Welcome here to Buena Vista, Virginia. I am Tyler Wright. I'll be commentating on today's USA South men's lacrosse matchup between your Southern Virginia University Knights and the Brevard College Tornadoes. Both these teams are looking to bounce back after maybe a start to the season that they weren't hoping for. Both these teams coming in with one win. Southern Virginia with a 1-8 record on the season so far. Brevard with a 1-6 record. Brevard's on the road here for their first in conference matchup of the season, looking to get off to a good start in the conference here today. SVU played Piedmont just a couple games ago for their first conference where they lost. Both teams looking to kind of curve the direction that their season is going so far, looking for that win to put their team in the right direction, getting some momentum for the season. So we get ready to prepare for this first quarter of play here. So looking at this matchup here today, both these teams are pretty similar. They have relatively smaller rosters, kind of, you know, less experience, a lot of freshmen, a lot of kind of figuring out to do as they kind of navigate how to work their way around this new team. You know, we have two experienced coaches here in this matchup today. We have Jason Lamb for Southern Virginia. He has quite the resume behind him. He was coaching for BYU from 1995 to 2010, where he led the BYU Cougars to men's College Lacrosse Association championships three times, also claiming seven Rocky Mountain lacrosse conference titles along the way. As we prepare for the game to start, we'll read off the starting lineups. For Southern Virginia, number one, Michael Brown playing defense. Number two, Gannon Lyles playing defensive midfield. Number three, Clay Hackey, midfield. Number seven, Scott Dupay, defensive midfield. Number eight, Zach Sullivan. Number nine, Richie Johnson playing defense. Number 11, Peyton Merwin will be offsides today with an injury. Number 13, River Jackson, playing midfield. Number 14, Wyatt Garrett, playing left side midfield. Number 16, Gabe King, playing midfield. Number 19, Jaden Arnold, playing forward. Number 20, Jacob Zollinger, playing defense. Number 21, JT Cutterer, playing defensive midfield. Number 29, Davis Grant, playing midfield. And number 30, Boston Schilleman, playing defensive midfield. That is your SVU Knights lineup as we get ready to have this opening face-off. Fighting for it. Looks like number 9 for the Knights will, or no, that's number 19 for the Knights will win the face-off. That is Jaden Arnold. Knights winning the face-off and get a quick shot on goal, and they make it. That is number 8, Zach Sullivan, the attacker. Nice start for the SU Knights here to get that quick goal. And that is how important these opening face-offs can be, you know, getting that opening momentum, getting the ball first, just quickly ripping one in the cage to get a point on the board. That is a good momentum start for the Knights here today. You know, both these teams so far, as we mentioned, you know, kind of not what they wanted so far on the season. And the Knights almost do the exact same thing again. Zach Sullivan takes a shot in the cage but misses it. So the Knights are going to get possession back. They're behind the cage. That's number 5. Tyson Mari leads the team with assists. He has 11 on the season so far for the Knights. There we go. Number 23, Porter Wells for the Knights. They're going to take that shot on goal, but he's going to miss on the outside of the wing. So Mari's going to take this ball back from behind the cage to the far side. It looks like Peyton Merwin is in the game. Number 11 there on the wing. He's going to cut in before passing it to number 8. That is Zach Sullivan again. But he overshoots it. Nice block by the goalkeeper there for Brevard, number 18, Scott Bundy. And they're just going to pass it back to Bundy as he moves his way outside of the shooting circle. And that'll go out of bounds for the Tornado, so the Knights will get possession of it here on the attacking side of the field. Knights advancing the ball slowly, kind of trying to create an opening in the Tornadoes' defense here. He's going to shoot it and overshot. That was number 3, Clay Hackey, with the shot. So the Knights here coming off quick and aggressive here in this first quarter of play so far. You know, the Knights have been kind of struggling on offense recently in the season, but you know, today is a good shift in momentum for the Knights. Tyson Mari is going to just shift his body around the cage, and he's going to get a shot, and that goes in. But it looks like they call a penalty, or no. Nope, that is in. Okay, they call it. That is number 5, Tyson Mari, with the shot on goal and the make. Knights now up 2-0 here in the first quarter. So entering this matchup here today, the Knights had 75 goals on the season compared to the opponent's 168. So this is exactly the type of start that the Knights wanted to do here today to get their offense running. So it looks like they're going to make a little change of lineup. Mari with the ball again, surveying the field. He's got a couple guys open. Looks like we have a substitution. That's number 13 for the Knights. River Jackson coming on the field, and number 3, Clay Hackey. And they're going to sub number 21, JT Cutter, on the sideline. They'll put Peyton Merwin back in the field. So Merwin has the ball now. Sullivan tries to make a move around some defenders. He had 2 on him, but loses the ball in the process. Nice pickup there by the goalkeeper for Brevard. As Brevard's going to be able to advance the ball onto the other side of the field. But the Knights are quickly able to recover. That's Jace Lightfoot, the freshman out of St. Augustine, Florida. But Knights going to get a penalty called against them. That's going to give possession to the Tornadoes here. Looks like Tornadoes are going to make a quick substitution. Number zero, Michael Peters, comes off the field. No, that wasn't number zero. That was number 40. Number 40, Atticus Cooper, coming off the field as Michael Peters, now on the field for the Brevard Tornadoes. So Brevard's going to recover possession here on their own defensive side of the field as the Knights pass goes out of bounds. Arching pass by the defender there to number, looks like number nine, Nate Stone. But Stone's going to lose possession, and that's number one for the Knights, Michael Brown, who has the ball. He's going to pass it down the side to Tyson Mari. Shot fended off there by the Tornadoes. Looks like the Tornadoes are going to try to reset just by passing the goalkeeper, Scott Bundy. Cross the field. Now the Tornadoes working behind the cage. Gage Kyatt with the ball. He's going to pass it back behind the cage. Going to pass it forward to Atticus Cooper. Cooper's going to motion behind the cage here. Try to shake a defender off. Oh. The pass to number 12. Number 12 takes the shot on goal. That's Jacob Hernandez, but he misses. Or it gets fended off by Jace Lightfoot in goal. So the Knights recover possession. Give it to Tyson Listenby, the midfielder. He takes the shot on goal. And he makes it. Tyson Listenby with a goal. What a play. Tyson Listenby charging the goal or the cage. And he quickly passed it to Tyson Maori, who passes it back. Nice assist there by Maori and the goal there by Tyson Listenby to make the score 3-0 in favor of the Southern Virginia Knights. So here we have the faceoff again. That's number 19 for the Knights. That is Arnold or Jaden Arnold again. It looks like Brevard's going to get this one. Number 50. Michael Brown able to scoop that up for the Knights as they work their way up the field. And, oh, another goal by the Knights there. That's number 21, JT Cutler. He's able to get that direct shot on goal, 1v1 the goalkeeper, and the goalkeeper just isn't at the right place. That just slides right by him. Knights now up 4-0. So like there's a little timeout here on the field. So Knights up 4-0 against their conference rival, the Brevard Tornadoes. Great start to the game so far here for the Knights. As you know, we mentioned, you know, the Knights coming off a couple games ago playing the Piedmont College for their first conference game. They got off to it was a 8-22 loss there. So, you know, this is a great confidence booster for the Knights here as they work to kind of bounce back in their in conference game. And it's kind of tough to navigate where these teams stand within the conference early on in the season like now. You know, Brevard hasn't even played a conference game yet. So this is their first. So Knights so far 0-1 on the season in conference. Brevard, you know, fresh slate 0-0. And it's kind of waiting to see how the conference shakes out early here in the season. But as we said before, you know, the in-conference game or out-of-conference games, both these teams, you know, kind of struggled. So it's great to see the Knights offense picking up here today. And Brevard, you know, still looking to make stuff happen here in the first quarter. You know, we mentioned how the Knights, you know, are outscored by opponents 75-168 coming into this game. Brevard similarly doing a little better. Their opponents outscoring them 90-46. So, you know, Brevard more of a defensive team. Able, you know, they've held their opponents about half the points that SVU has. But SVU was able to get the upper hand on him so far today. So the faceoff here. Looks like that's number 30 for the Knights. Boston Schilliman for the Brevard College Tornadoes. That's number 50, who is not listed on the roster. And the Knights are going to win that faceoff. Schilliman's going to take the ball and pass it to number 14, White Garrett, who's going to cut his way through some defenders, but Scott Bundy's going to be able to fend that off. Nice save there by the goalkeeper for Brevard. Max Dorman, the midfielder for the Tornadoes, going to be surveying the field. He's going to pass it. Tornadoes on the far side trying to get some players open, but Michael Brown has him locked down, but he's going to motion and get out of there. Going to pass it back to Atticus Cooper. Freed up, that's number 7, Will Scoggins. Scoggins looking for someone to throw it to, but there's just Knights defenders all over the field. They're going to motion the ball back behind the cage. Jace Lightfoot, the goalkeeper for the Knights, already in position. Cooper is going to... Oh! Cooper takes the shot around the corner, but Jace Lightfoot is able to knock it away with his stick. But the Tornadoes are able to recover possession of the ball. They're able to rebound this and try to take another shot on goal, but a little misstep in the pass there, and the Knights are going to be able to regain possession of the ball. Lightfoot now with the ball. As the Knights work their way up the field. Little scuffle here. It looks like the Brevard Tornadoes might have a chance to recover the ball, but it's picked up by number 4 for the Knights. That is Ben Slugga. Ben Slugga, freshman from Heber City, Utah, able to get that ball, but it's going to go out of bounds. So the Tornadoes are going to get possession of it here. So a nice change of pace for the Tornadoes here. You know, most of the game they've been working on their own side of the field, but they're able to get a decent series here on the attack as they look for their first points of the game. Nice move there. Looks like that's number 11 for the Tornadoes. That is Parker Corbett, who actually leads the team in goals. Able to maneuver his way around the defender, but the shot gets blocked. Cooper Atticus Nice defender has the ball. He's going to pass it up. Little miss there, so the Tornadoes now recover. But they sling the ball out of bounds. Another timeout here with 6 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Knights still up 4-0. Talked a little bit about Jason Lamb, the coach for the SVU Knights. The coach for Brevard, you know, also has tons of lacrosse experience under his belt. This is his third season coaching the Tornadoes here. He actually played Division III lacrosse himself at Mitchell College in Connecticut and was a three-year captain. So, no, he has leadership ability. He knows what he's doing when it comes to this game. No, he actually was a goalkeeper for Mitchell College, where he set the school record with 773 saves and was the three-time goalkeeper of the year for his conference as well as first-team all-conference in the New England Collegiate Conference. Before his stint here at Brevard College, he was the men's and women's head coach at Missouri Valley College in the NAIA. So tons of experience, both men's and women's lacrosse. Now, that says a lot for a program to be able to trust one man with both their men's and women's program. So he was able to kickstart their program. And here he is with Brevard College, trying to get them to the next step in their competitive ways. So the players are going to make their way to their sides of the field as we look here to resume play. Looks like Jace Lightfoot, the goalkeeper of the night, is going to put the ball back into play. He's going to pass it to JT Cutrer, who's going to slide past the defender. Takes a shot, but it's a little short. Bounces off the ground over the net. But the Knights are able to recover. That's number 29 with the recovery, Davis Grant. Knights going to switch out a couple players. Peyton Merwin with the ball. Knights maneuvering the ball around the net, just passing, trying to find that opening to get the good shot on the goal. Porter Wells able to pass it to Tyson Maury. It looks like that ball is going to slide past the goalie, Scott Bundy. Looks like that's another point for the Knights. Knights now up 5-0. Hard to tell in the scuffle who made it in, but I believe that was number 3, Clay Hackey. Looks like the ball just kind of dropped on the ground and kind of just rolled into the net, kind of just past the goalkeeper completely by surprise there. But nonetheless, it's still a point for the Knights. Knights able to win this faceoff. Number 14, Wyatt Garrett able to scoop the ball up while no one's looking. And the Tornadoes are going to be able to regain possession quickly. There was number 1, Tyler Cameron, trying to cradle the ball, but just had two defenders on him, was able to cradle it securely, and it falls out of bounds. Knights get possession here. And Hackey with the shot on goal, and he's going to get that again to put it up 6-0 for the Knights. That ball is seen a little short, just bounces off the ground and straight into the net. Knights off to a spectacular start here in the first quarter. 4 minutes left in regulation play for the first quarter. Face-off here, looks like the Tornadoes are going to win this one, but penalty is called against the Knights, and so the Tornadoes are going to regain possession. Atticus Cooper working his way to the side. He's going to pass it. Looks like the Tornadoes are getting a little aggressive here. Quickly trying to pass the ball before the Knights know what's happening. Trying to open something up quickly. Nice grab there by number 27 for the Tornadoes, getting on his knees. That's Gabe Kyatt. Ekis Cooper behind the net. He's going to try to pass it. Bunch of bodies in there. Hitting the ball up in the air. Looks like the Tornadoes are going to come up with that. Number 11, Parker Corbett, just launches the ball way out of the field. So the Knights are going to get possession. You know, talking a little bit about Parker Corbett as we have today, you know, as we mentioned, he leads the team in goals for this Tornado lacrosse team. And he's been such a key player. As you see, you know, here today, he's an integral part of this attack here for Brevard College. And, you know, he hasn't been featured in such a prominent way as he has in the past games. But, you know, if this team's going to kind of get into that red hot start that they're hoping to get here in the closing minutes of the first quarter, they're probably hoping to get him more involved in the game. Nice. Passing it down, trying to open things up for their attack. That ball's going to roll out of bounds. And the Knights are going to pick it up. Number 10, Forrest Ambridge, is going to pick it up here for the Knights. Surveying the field, looking for someone to throw it to. He's going to throw it to Sullivan. He's going to quickly pass it. Great save there by the goalkeeper, Scott Bundy. Number 3, Clay Hackey, just launches it towards the cage, but Bundy just puts his body right in front of it. Porter Wells with the ball. They're just going to send the ball down the field. Towards the midfield, I should say. Then I try to manipulate the defenders more towards the midfield, trying to open up the area in front of the cage. Forrest Ambridge is going to try to make a move. They're going to pass it. Oh! Shot there by number 29. Kind of bounces off the rim. Davis Grant just hits the side of the cage. Looks like the ref is going to throw a flag. Give possession back to the Knights. Knights working from behind the cage. Little assist there by Tyson Mallory to Zach Sullivan, but the shot's a little off. Timeout here. Or no, that's the end of the quarter. First quarter draws to a close here with the Knights up 6-0 against their in-conference rival, the Brevard College Tornadoes. So far, Clay Hackey with 2 goals on the day for the Knights and 4 other scorers. It's been a good day for the Knights' attack. Brevard looking to kind of shift things around, try to create more opportunities to score here in the second quarter. So Knights doing a good job both offensively and defensively here today. Able to keep the Brevard Tornadoes from scoring any points here in the first quarter and able to put 6 on the Tornadoes here. As we mentioned, you know, the Knights kind of had a rough patch here in the first part of the season, but if, you know, this first quarter is an indicator for the rest of the season, you know, the Knights are off to a wonderful beginning here as they begin to finish out the season playing the rest of their conference games, looking to make a standing within the conference, you know, make a deep run within the conference tournament for the USA South, possibly a bid for the postseason. Looks like we're setting up here for the face-off to begin the second quarter. We'll be switching sides of the field. For all you listeners out there, you know, thank you for watching this production by Knights Broadcasting. Please like and subscribe and leave a comment. Tell us what you've enjoyed about this game and maybe ways that we can enhance this experience. Looks like that's number 19 for the Knights. Jaden Arnold back in for the face-off. And they're just going to give that to the Knights. Another quick goal here for the Knights here. 7-0. And that's Clay Hackey, who is credited with that goal. So that makes his 3rd of the day. Knights beginning this quarter exactly how they started the last quarter, able to quickly win that faceoff, drive down the field, and get a quick goal. Looks like we have number 7 here for the faceoff. Will Scoggins for Brevard College, and number 30, Boston Schilliman here for SVU to begin this faceoff. So the Knights are going to have the ball. Listen B is able to get the ball to the attacking side of the field for the Knights, giving it to number 21, who passed it to Sullivan, number 8. Looks like the Knights players coming off the field. Number 3 just came in. Clay Hackey, he's going to get the ball. He's going to take a shot, but it's blocked by the goalkeeper. All going wild on the ground there. A couple of bodies diving for it, trying to get it, but ultimately it floats out of bounds. And possession is given to the Tornadoes. Number 2, Eddie Bell, able to make some moves, but eventually gets pushed out of bounds by the Knights. He's going to lose that ball, but they're going to call a penalty on that. So the Knights changing their lineup a little bit. Same as the Tornadoes. So it looks like there'll be an unsportsmanlike penalty. It looks like number 40, Atticus Cooper, is going to be given the ball on the attacking side of the field. So now Brevard will be able to work on their opponent's side of the field, as a result of that penalty. Long shot there taken by number 27, Gage Kyatt for the Tornadoes, trying to get the first goal of the game here for Brevard, but goes to the side of the goal. Number 11 makes his way around. Looks like Kay is able to take another shot, but misses the cage. But looks like number 11, Parker Corbett's going to be able to recover the ball as he was the closest to when it went out of bounds. Looks like there's a problem with the shot clock. So they're going to quickly resume play after they fix that. Corbett with the ball. Corbett is going to circle around the cage, try to get a shot off, but Jace Lightfoot is able to knock it out with his stick. So Jace Lightfoot now working outside of the cage. Number 14, Wyatt Garrett able to drop the ball, but the Knights are able to quickly recover. That's Michael Brown sprinting down the side of the field. He's going to try to pass to Merwin, but oh! So it looks like the pass was looking like it was intended for Merwin, but it bounces off the ground. That's number 21, JT Cutler, who's able to get that deflection off the ground and make a goal. Able to take that shot, putting them up 8-0. JT now with his second score of the game. Knights now have two players with multiple scores. Face off here again. Looks like Brevard's able to hit it towards the attack, but the Knights are going to be able to quickly scoop it up. So the Knights are going to be working down the field. The Tornadoes have the ball now. Number 2, Eddie Bell's going to make his way down the field, down the far side. Looks like he's going to motion behind the cage. Parker Corbett right outside the cage in perfect scoring position. Bryce Peterson with the ball right now for Brevard. He's going to pass it down the field towards midfield. Brevard going to run behind the cage again. Try to set up some sort of offensive sequence here. Atticus Cooper with the ball. He's going to try to motion around the defender. Cooper is going to try to pass it, but ball hits the ground and rolls out of bounds, so the Knights will get possession here. Clay Hackey's going to get the ball to start with. Sullivan's going to make his way towards the cage. He's going to take a shot, but it's off target, and that rolls out of bounds. The Knights with the ball still. They're going to pass it back to Hackey. Porter Wells drops the ball. Tornado is able to quickly get possession and run to the other side of the field. Oh, geez, number 14. Looks like that was a midfielder. Jacob Gravely able to take the shot, but that goes directly into the net of the stick of Jace Lightfoot, the goalkeeper for the Knights. So the Knights now working around the cage. Tyson Mori trying to shake off a defender, trying to maneuver around him. He's going to pass it back to Merwin. Haki to Sullivan. Sullivan's going to open shot on the net. And that went in. Clay Haki. Or no, that was Sullivan. Zach Sullivan now with his second goal of the game. Just got the right angle, got the right spot of the net, the upper corner. And that just zooms past Scott Bundy there. Knights now up 9-0 here on the faceoff. Number 30. Boston Schilleman able to knock that behind them so the Knights get the ball. Maori just cradling the ball, trying to find an open player. Maori still with the ball. He's going to pass it to Clay Haki. River Jackson with the ball. He's going to drop it while he's cradling it, but he's going to be able to scoop it right back up. He's going to pass it back to Tyson Maori. Clay Haki with his fourth goal. Puts the Knights up 10-0. Here's the faceoff. Looks like the Knights are going to fight for it. Number 50 for Brevard. He's able to kind of stave off the attack, but eventually the Knights are going to be able to grab the ball here. It's number 48 who's able to get that. Tyson Mori with the ball. He's going to pass it straight back to number 21, who's able to get the shot and makes the goal. That was number 21, JT Cutler, who now has his third goal of the game. They're going to give that to Tyson Mari. So Tyson Mari with the goal there, they say, is the call. Number 19 able to win that faceoff pretty quickly. Jaden Arnold is able to run down the field. Shot over the cage, though, but Knights retain possession. Ben Slugga making his way towards midfield, but he's going to pass it to Clay Haki. You know, Haki's just had a tremendous game so far today. You know, the sophomore from Syracuse, Utah, from Syracuse High School, has four goals today. Going to pass it to Merwin, who's going to pass it behind the cage. Knights making it full circle. River Jackson. Back to Merwin. Merwin able to maneuver around the Tornadoes defender. And that's another goal. Number three, Clay Hackey, the man of the hour. We were just talking about him. Fifth goal of the game for Hackey. That just zoomed right in there. He straight direct shot into the cage, straight past the goalkeeper. What a day for Hackey. Not even into the second half. Hackey now with 5 goals on the game. Hackey is right behind Gabe King coming into this game for leading the team in goals. He had 18, King had 19. And another shot here and a goal by the Knights. Number 14. Wyatt Garrett, the sophomore from Lake Mary, Florida, able to put it up 13-0 against the Tornadoes here today. And so a timeout's going to be called. And so on a day like today for the Knights, you know, everything just seems to be clicking. Everything seems to be working your way. And if you're Brevard, you know, you're down 13-0 here. 6 minutes till the half. No, kind of probably wondering, you know, what you can do to kind of claw your way back into this game. Both these teams, as we mentioned, still looking for that first conference win. You know, if you're SVU right now, you know, of course you're happy with the result, but, you know, looking down the stretch of the season, you know, a convincing win here today would be good in the long run, you know, in the conference standings. Games like today is what earns you respect within the conference. So play resumes here with 6:30 left in the first half. So Jaden Arnold here for the Knights for the faceoff. And the Knights are going to quickly get the ball, but whistle's blown by the refs. And the ball will be given to the Tornadoes. Number 9, Nate Stone, able to work his way around some defenders, able to edge him out on the sideline. Stone's going to cradle the ball and kind of make his way behind the cage. Stone's going to try to pass it to number 22. That is Bryce Peterson, but he's going to miss the mark, and it's going to slowly roll out of bounds as a few players down the field try to fight for the ball, but Brevard is going to get possession. So there's Kayat cradling the ball. He's going to pass it to Cooper. Peterson to Corbett. Back to Peterson. They're just passing it back and back, trying to open up something. Jace Lightfoot in position. And that's going to go past Lightfoot. So the Brevard College Tornadoes with their first goal of the game. Nice shot there by number 27, Gage Kyatt, the sophomore from Mesa, Arizona, Red Mountain High School. You know, Lightfoot, he was in position for that, but you know, the shot was probably a little lower than expected. Kind of just rolls past his foot. So, Tornadoes now on the board, 13-1. Face-off here between number 30 and number 7. Number 30 for the Knights, able to get the ball. That is Boston Schilleman. Looks like Sullivan has the ball here for the Knights. Cradling it, but he's going to advance towards the cage, but it's blocked there by Scott Bundy, the goalkeeper. He's another shot there, but Bundy's going to scoop it up and give the ball to the Tornadoes. Nice defense there by number one, Michael Brown, with the long stick, able to knock the ball out. Slugga able to pass to Morey there. Tyson Morey just trying to shake off some defenders as a couple of Knights players are going to run off the field. Some fresh legs for the Knights, number 23 and 10. Porter Wells with a shot on goal, and he makes that. Porter Wells makes it 14-1 in favor of the Knights. What a day for the Knights' attack. 14 goals here with 4 minutes left in the first half. So we have the face-off again. Number 7, Will Scoggins versus number 30, Boston Schilleman for the Knights. And Schilleman's going to get that ball quickly for the Knights. But Skiggins able to kind of knock that away, but it's quickly recovered. Maori cradling the ball. Waiting for some new SVU players off the sidelines to come out. They're going to give that to River Jackson. Clay Hackey with the ball. He's going to pass it to Sullivan, who's quickly going to maneuver the ball kind of around the corner, but they're going to kind of get the ball to make its way on the other side of the field. Little back and forth between Merwin and Maury. Payne Warren able to run past the defender. And Merwin with the assist and the goal by Hackey. Clay Hackey now with 6 on the day. Came in this game with 18, now has 24 in total on the season. Knights now up 15-1 with less than 3 minutes remaining in the first half. Arnold originally thought he got that face off, but the Tornadoes player able to kind of get the ball free, but the Knights are still going to end up with it. Knights players making their way, setting a position around the cage. Quick little substitution at midfield. River Jackson and Forrest Ambridge now on the field. They're going to make another quick substitution. Knights ball making full circle. Porter Wells cradling the ball, trying to maneuver his way around the defender. He's going to pass it. Sullivan. River Jackson kind of shaking off the defender. He's going to pass it behind the cage to Maury. Brevard defender with the long stick trying to knock the ball out, and he does. That's number 24. Max Dorman able to kind of hit that ball out with his long stick. And that'll give the Tornadoes a much-needed possession. And the ball gets taken by the Knights here. And number 48, able to run up straight to the goal, one-on-one with the goalkeeper, and he makes that. That's Finley. Isaac Finley for the Southern Virginia Knights with his first goal of the day. So the Knights have just been dominating today. You know, here we are at the faceoff again. And the Knights have been doing really well with the faceoffs. Here they do again. Looks like a real scuffle. A lot of players, but the Knights are going to eventually emerge with the ball. That's number 21. He's going to run straight for the goal, but he's going to pass it to Sullivan. A little back and forth between Sullivan and Davis Grant. Porter Wells with the ball. He's going to pass it back to River Jackson. Had a couple defenders on him. So he's going to put it behind the cage. Shot clock winding down. You can hear the fans counting down. They're just going to kind of try to make a pass. It's going to go out of bounds. So here we go. Tornadoes with possession. 3 seconds left. And that will be the first half. Knights on top, 16-1 here. So, great game here by the Knights so far, up 16-1 on their opponent, the Brevard College Tornadoes. And Clay Hackey certainly leading the way here for the Knights with 6 goals so far today. JT Cutler also with 3 goals on the day, Zach Sullivan with 2. So we have 3 Knights players with multiple goals. And the Tornadoes were able to sneak one past the goalkeeper to make it 16-1. So, you know, coming into this game, you know, we kind of mentioned both these teams looked very similar, kind of, you know, on the way they played, the way their rosters looked. But, you know, the Knights have kind of taken that step and have shown their grit here today. We will now be taking a short break here at halftime. We'll be back shortly. Welcome back here to the second half of play here in Buena Vista, Virginia, here at Knight Stadium. As we prepare for the face-off here between Logan Southern of Brevard College and Jaden Arnold of Southern Virginia. Knights so far have won 17 of the 19 face-offs, and they're going to win this one here today, at this moment. Miori with a quick pass to 21, but he's going to drop that. And the Tornadoes are able to pick that ball up. But quickly, Miori for the Knights is going to be able to pick that back up and take a shot. But it's going to be to the side of the cage. So a little switch up here for the Tornadoes here in the second half. Looks like number 10, Jack Hicks will be in goal, replacing Scott Bundy for the Tornadoes. So Hicks now with the ball, he's going to pass it out. Hicks is going to center the ball in the field, giving it to number 2, Eddie Bell. And Bell's going to kind of work his way, kind of split defenders, but he's going to lose the ball in the process. And River Jackson's going to pick that up and run straight for the goal. And River Jackson drops it. So now Hicks, the goalkeeper, has the ball. Looks like Jackson's going to try to fight him for it. Eddie Bell tries to dive for that ball, but drops it. It's going to go in the feet of Hackey. Tyson Morey's going to pass it to Hackey. Hackey's going to try to pass it to Porter Wells, but it's going to roll out of bounds. So here we have the Tornadoes with possession. Number 27, Gage Kyatt, with the lone score for the Tornadoes here today. He's going to put the ball back in play. And they're going to throw that over the midfield, but it's going to get caught by the Knights. See, we have number, looks like that's 36, Preston Billings, who's going to see some action here today. So the Knights with the ball just barely outside of midfield. Just pass it back and forth. Work their way down the side now, the near side. So Sullivan right now with the ball. Ambridge is going to advance the ball. He's going to drop it, but quickly recovers it himself. So Ambridge is just going to throw it back to Sullivan. Gives it to Wells. Great pass. Kind of threads the needle between two Tornado defenders and gives it to Sullivan, but Sullivan tries to take a shot, but it bounces off a stick. It's going to go out of bounds. So the Knights now have the ball. Hackey and Miori back and forth. Grant to Sullivan. Knights just passing the ball around, trying to open up some space, trying to draw some defenders. And Hackey's going to make his advance towards the net. He's going to pass to Miori behind the cage. Sullivan now has it, making some moves around defenders. Looks like number 0, Michael Peters, is able to get his long stick on the ball, but number 23, Porter Wells, is quickly able to recover it, put it behind the cage to Maori, who's just going to kind of toss it out of bounds, giving it to the Tornadoes. So Brevard College now with the ball, with the chance to go on the attack, making their way through the midfield. He's going to get knocked down by the Knights players. Number 21 able to knock him down. That's JT Cutler. He's able to get the ball. So he's cradling the ball right now, but he's going to pass it down to Tyson Mowry. Going to work behind the cage for now. A little back and forth here. Trying to draw some tornado defenders. But for the most part, they slowly advance, but they remain put. So the Knights are just going to charge them, put on the attack. Porter Wells has the ball, makes a move. Number 5, Tyson Mowry tries to cut around the corner. Looks like he had it open for a minute, but a few defenders close by able to stop that from getting a clear shot and goal. And so the Tornadoes are going to be able to gain possession of the ball. A little scuffle, players kind of hitting each other, trying to get it. It looks like the Brevard College Tornadoes are going to come up with the ball here at the end. Number 27, Gage Kayet, running down the field, full stride, making his way behind the net. He's just going to get rid of the ball here. So now the Knights have it. And they're going to give that to Brevard, it looks like. Determining they were closer. So Atticus Cooper now has the ball close to midfield. He's going to try to motion some players open. Nice dive there by Kayette. Brevard circling the cage. Cooper tries to check number 21. There was Corbett there with the shot on goal, but off the target. But thankfully, there was a Tornado player close to the rear sideline, so they're able to get the ball back here. Try to take shot number 2. Some defenders trying to hit the ball out with their long stick. Jax Mitchum trying to get Corbett to lose the ball, and he's going to pass it to Kayat, who doesn't hold the ball in. So a little scuffle here between Skiggins and Garrett. But ultimately, Garrett for the SVU Knights is going to get possession of it. But they're going to put Clay Hackey on the side. He's going to run it in. So the Knights have the ball. Hackey. As we said, Hackey has 6 goals on the day. The sophomore. You know, Hackey saw quite a bit of action last season as a freshman. Was actually 2nd. On the team and goals scored with 27. And here he is as a sophomore. Now, after this game, leading the team. Was only 1 behind the lead scorer, Gabe King. But Hackey with his 6 goals so far today most certainly surpasses that. So it looks like Merwin and Soldner is going to pass it back and forth a few times. Peyton Merwin is going to make an advance, but number 27, Kayette, able to knock him down and get the ball out of him. So Kayette able to get the ball to the Tornadoes in a much-needed attempt on goal. But looks like Atticus Cooper is going to drop that. And so the midfield is going to be able to grab it for the Knights. And Tyson Mowry with the goal there. Number 5, Tyson Maori with the assist from Isaac Finley. Knights now up 17-1. So 6:27 left in the third quarter. Knights able to score the first goal here in the second half. Or no. The second one. No, it was the first, yeah. So the Knights able to take a shot. Number 4, Ben Slugga. But it's going to zoom behind the net. But the Knights are able to retain possession. A little pass around here for the Knights. Tornadoes trying not to break formation. As the Knights start to collapse their formation, River Jackson's going to try to charge number 2, Eddie Bell. Eddie Bell's not going to give, so Jackson's going to let the ball loose, passing it to his teammates. Maori circling the cage, able to tries to pass it to Jackson, but he's going to drop it. He had 2 defenders on him, so it looks like the goalkeeper, Hicks, is going to pick up the ball for Brevard. As they cross midfield, they're going to lose possession, though. So it looks like player's going to be sent to the penalty box for the Knights. Number 5, Tyson Maori. He's had quite a game today. Done a lot of work behind the net for the Knights, or behind the cage. So he'll be there for a minute as play resumes. So here's number 21 for the Knights with a clear look downfield, JT Cutler. Grant, behind the net, is going to give it to Sullivan. Sullivan had about 3 defenders on him, hitting him with their stick, but he's able to get out of that. Porter Wells with the ball. Wells kind of surveying the field, trying to look for someone to throw it to. Knights with a couple players behind the cage. Forrest Ambridge with the ball. Here's Maori back from the penalty box. Brevard College was playing man up. But the Knights able to recover the ball, so they weren't able to take advantage of that. Maori with the assist to Sullivan. Straight from the penalty box, able to make an instant impact, able to pass that ball to Sullivan. And Sullivan, straight right in front of the shooting circle, able to make that goal. Putting the Knights up 18-1. So Sullivan now with 3 goals as well for the game. As we prepare here for another face-off, who we have Logan Southern and Boston Schilliman. And the Knights were able to grab this It's Isaac Finley with his long stick able to hole in that ball. Exits the midfield zone. Onto the attack. Trying to take that shot, but his long stick kind of launches that ball way over the net. But thankfully, Grant was there to... They're near the sideline, so the Knights are able to retain possession. Knights working in the midfield. River Jackson stepping deeper and deeper into the midfield zone, but he's going to charge. He's going to work his way around Michael Peters. But eventually just going to relent the ball there to Tyson Mowry. Shot clock winding down. Knights get the shot off to relieve pressure. Didn't hit the net, so shot clock still winding down. And the shot clock hits zero. So that'll give the ball to Brevard, who now has their 80 seconds. Eddie Bell with a ball, but he drops it. Knights able to recover it. Nice move there by Mowry. Looks like he was about to pass it, but saw the defender right there, so he kept the ball. That's number two. Gannon Lyles now for the Knights. A little back and forth between Merwin and Hackey. Less than a minute left remaining in the third quarter. Hackey making his way through some defenders. Going to pass it behind the cage. Sullivan going to make some moves. Couldn't really tell if that was a attentive shot or he was trying to pass that to someone, but it's going to bounce out of bounds either way. Mowry behind the net. He's going to give it to Sullivan. He's going to take a shot on the goal with the final seconds wearing down of the shot clock, but he's going to miss. So 4 seconds left on the shot clock for the Knights here. They have to quickly make a shot on goal. They either have the goalie hit it or hit the cage to reset the 60 seconds. Looks like they were just going to lob it up there to kind of wear out as much clock as they can. Only 17 seconds left in the quarter. Number 17 for the Tornadoes, Nick Charania, trying to move his way down the field to make something happen, but Tyson Mowry for the Knights is going to pick it up with the final few seconds of this quarter. And that will be it for the third quarter here today. Knights up 18-1 against the Tornadoes of Brevard College. So Jason Lamb with the good game plan today. You can tell these Knights players have been working hard. You know, as we mentioned, the season hasn't exactly come forth so far the way that they would have hoped, though, 1-8 on the season. But here they are looking for their second win of the season here today. And they've been playing excellent. You know, Jason Lamb's doing a wonderful job with these men. No, Jason Lamb actually recently being inducted into the MCLA Hall of Fame for, you know, everything he's done for the MCLA and just lacrosse in general. The MCLA, of course, being the Men's Collegiate Lacrosse Association, where he coached BYU to 3 national titles. So, Jason Lamb, you know, been around the game a long time, knows what he's doing. And, you know, SVU is really pleased with what he's done and everything he's done for this program. We'd like to take a brief moment to thank our sponsors. We have Cornerstone Bank, Straws Eat and Drinks, River Crossing Apartments, Vinyl Cuts and Gifts, Grace Automotive, The Beeve Sweet Souvenirs, Mill Creek Orthodontics, Papa John's locally owned and operated, and Katana Sushi and Hibachi Express. You know, we appreciate our sponsors and for their promotion of Knights Athletics. So we are with a face-off, Logan Southern for Brevard and Jaden Arnold for the Knights. Looks like the Knights are able to quickly get it, but looks like that's number one, Corbett, for the Tornadoes, trying to fight for the ball, and he eventually gets it. Hits it out of the Knights' hands, so it's recovered. But the Knights get in. That's Tyson Morey with a goal. Tyson Morey. Knights now up 19-1. What a series of events that unfold for the Knights. So here we are again with the face-off. Southern and Schilliman. And Schilliman able to hit the ball between the legs of Southern, but Southern is able to quickly recover it. And he quickly passes it off before running off sides. And so here we have another penalty. So the ref throws the flag down. Looks like Davis Grant was also credited with an assist on that last goal by Morey. So here we go. Penalty against the Knights. Looks like number 9 for Brevard College. Nate Stone's going to be able to advance that ball. They're just going to pass it around. The Knights defender is trying to look for an opening. So Atticus Cooper with the ball. He's going to pass it to Parker Corbett. Stone to Cooper. Pass to Parker Cooper, who's in perfect position to make a move on the cage, but unable to hold that ball in. Atticus Cooper right by the cage trying to motion that he's open. Corbett, don't know if he was passing that to Cooper to try to get a near shot on the cage or if he was trying to shoot that himself. Kind of split them. Cooper is making some moves around Michael Brown, but number 14 able to whack him with his stick, Wyatt Garrett, able to set the ball loose. Tornadoes now with the ball again. But they're just going to let that slide past the rear sideline. Looks like Jace Lightfoot's going to be coming out of the cage for a bit. Or no, it looks like they switched it up. Looks like they're putting in Daniel Gould here as goalkeeper. So Knights with possession of the ball, kind of working their way in the midfield zone. Porter Wells is going to try to maneuver around some defenders. He's going to take a shot on goal, but it goes over. Over the top bar. So it goes out of bounds. But the Knights still have possession. Davis Grant circling around the cage. Hackey able to shake off some defenders before passing it to Sullivan. Miori's going to try to take a low shot. Shot clock winding down. But it's recovered by Brevard. Number 24, Max Dorman looking for someone to throw it to. He's just going to pass it to Hicks, the goalkeeper, as they try to work it down the far sideline, but it's going to get taken by the Knights. And Tyson Mori with a one-on-one on the goalkeeper, and he scores! Tyson Mori now with his, I believe that's his third goal. So Mori with the assist from Zach Sullivan there to give the Knights 20 on the day so far. So now we have three, not including Clay Hackey, we have three other Knights players with three goals on the day. Tyson Mori, Jay Cutler, and Zach Sullivan. So the Knights working their ball around the cage. Going to pass it back to Mori. A little back and forth between River Jackson and Clay Hackey. Clay Hackey's going to kind of maneuver around this defender here. He's going to take a shot on goal. Dang! And he gets that. 21-1. Knights on top. So Clay Hackey able to just maneuver around these defenders and take a shot and goal. There was a bunch of players kind of between him and the goal, but he had a clear enough, I guess, side of goal. He able to take that shot a little outside the shooting circle, but he's able to hold that in. Looks like some sort of, here we go with the faceoff. Logan Southern able to get that for the Tornadoes, but the Knights able to beat the ball out of him. So they're able to advance it on the attack. So we have Tyson Mori cradling the ball. Sullivan's going to make his way up the numbers. Little back and forth between Porter Wells and River Jackson before they pass it to Merwin. Brevard College slowly shifting more towards the cage, not wanting to give weight to this Knights offense. Eddie Bell trying to stave off number 13 River Jacks for the Knights. He's going to try to move in towards the cage, but he's going to drop the ball, and Peyton Merwin's going to try to take a shot. But Hicks is able to put his body in the way and save that. So River Jackson looks like it's a little call called on him. So it looks like River Jackson was called for delay of game. So he'll be sitting in the penalty box for now. So Brevard College will be playing man up for now, as they have the ball, trying to get some offensive things going here in the final quarter of play. Passing it back and forth, trying to open up this Knights defense. A little nice back and forth. Parker Corbett trying to pass it behind the cage to a couple of players, but you can see a little frustration there. He misses the shot. Number 9, Nate Stone. Looks like he was trying to take a shot, but it goes past the cage. Cooper trying to cut through a lot of Knight defenders. But eventually the Knight defenders want to take the ball. The midfielder number 14, Wyatt Garrett, able to advance the ball all the way up the field. Hicks playing outside the cage, passing it to Stone, who's going to advance the ball through the midfield zone before passing it onto the attack. Parker Corbett, one-on-one with a goalie, but Gould is able to block that from getting into the cage. Michael Brown making his way up the far sideline before passing it to Sullivan. Sullivan passes it to Ambridge, a pair of fresh legs, as Jackson is back on the field from the penalty box. Miori back behind the cage, able to open up the other side of the field for the Knights, as Ambridge circles around. Nice save there by number 10, Hicks. And the Tornadoes able to hit the ball out of there. Potentially dangerous situation avoided there for Brevard College here in the waning minutes of this game. A little scuffle between Forrest Ambridge. And looks like that's number 0, Michael Peters, trying to hit the ball free, but eventually more players come in. Peyton Merwin of the Knights is able to get the ball for the Knights. River Jackson backing it up, trying to cut into the defenders, trying to get a shot, trying to create an opening, but something's called. Here's Dorman for Brevard advancing the ball through the mid zone. Eddie Bell kind of fumbles the ball a little bit, but is able to hold it in. A little scuffle. had about three nice defenders on him. So it looks like number 10 for the Knights, Forrest Ambridge, was cross-checked by somebody. Couldn't really see who. There's a lot of bodies there. So they're going to call. Looks like they're going to call number 9 for the Knights, Richie Johnson, for an illegal body check. So he'll be going to the penalty box. See Eddie Bell for Brevard College. Kind of walking off. Seems to be in a little pain. So we'll pause play here for a bit. This is number 9 for the Knights. Richie Johnson will be in the penalty box. As the players go to their respective side of the field. A little over 5 minutes left of regulation time. So the Tornadoes will be able to start with the ball on the attack. Tornadoes able to get 15 shots so far today. One of them going in. So Parker Corbett able to cradle the ball. Number 40, Atticus Cooper with the shot. But Gould is able to stave that. Nice save there by the freshman goalkeeper. Number 27, Kayat with the shot. You could hear it from up here. It hit the bar on the cage. Did not go in. They're going to give that to Gould as a save. And Kayat's able to get the ball past Gould for the score. Second goal of the day for Kayat. Looks like Cooper there with the assist, able to hand the ball out to Kayat with a right in front of the goalie and just slides past Gould there. So now 21-2. Knights still ahead. It's a little scuffle after the face off, but the Knights are eventually going to get the ball. Looks like some sticks are getting locked up. As the Knights are able to work on the attack right now. So the Knights with 54 shots taken compared to now 18 for Brevard College. And that just kind of sums up, you know, what we've seen so far today. The Knights were able to just, right off the bat, be fast and aggressive, and that momentum kind of just carried them throughout the rest of the game. So Porter Wells is going to make his way towards the cage. He's going to take a shot, and he gets it. So Porter Wells making it 22-2. In favor of the Knights. So the face-off here between Schilleman and Southern again. Finley with the ball. He's going to try to pass it. Number two, Gannon Lyles, is going to grab the ball off the ground. Advance the ball to the attack zone. Maori with the ball, kind of just surveying the field, circling around, waiting for the new players on the field to take position. Maury kind of pointing them in the direction he wants them to go, trying to set something up. So River Jackson's going to take the ball. Going to pass it to the far side. Inching closer and closer to the cage as they pass the ball back and forth. Peyton Merwin's going to pass it to Sullivan, who's going to kind of go back and forth. Forrest Ambridge takes a shot, but the goalkeeper, Hicks, is able to just hold it in his stick. He's going to launch that to the far side. Number one, Michael Peters. Ref's going to blow the whistle. Seems like a timeout was taken. A minute and a half here to go in the game. SVU players seeming really excited on the sidelines. About to come off with their first conference win of the season. So they'll be 1-1 leaving today in conference. And as we mentioned before, this is Brevard College's first conference game. So they'll be starting their conference slate 0-1 on the season. Teams are getting ready to go back to play. So number 18, Scott Bundy, who started the game as the goalkeeper, will now be in on the attack. So Kyatt, they scored the two goals for Brevard. He's going to hand it off to Atticus Cooper. Gould's able to hold that in from the cage. He's going to pass that to Kutcher. A lot of bodies in front of the cage. Tyson Morey with the ball. Ref's going to blow his whistle. River Jackson is going to beat out the defender, but Dorman's going to hit him with his stick, and he's going to fall and lose the ball. So now Nate Stone, number 9 for Brevard, is going to run down the field, try to pass to Cooper, but it's too high, and time will run out, and that is game. The Knights emerge victorious, 22-2 here, home at Knights Stadium against the in-conference Brevard College Tornadoes, and what a game it was for the Knights attack, outscoring their opponent by 20. As we mentioned coming into this game, you know, their scoring wasn't the best, scoring 75 points on the season compared to the opponent's 168. So today was a definite change of pace, You know, a lot earlier in the season, you know, teams will often schedule, you know, those harder opponents, those tougher opponents out of conference. So when they come to games like this against their conference opponents, you know, they're prepared. And so, you know, this kind of slower start to the season, you know, maybe contribute to that. Who knows? But today's exactly what the SVU Knights needed to kind of kickstart the rest of their season. And, you know, as we said, Clay Hackey, the man of the game, ends with 7 total goals scored for the Knights. And for the Brevard College Tornadoes, we have Kayak with 2. Tyson Miori also with 3 goals and 4 assists on the day. So all around, just a great game for the Knights offense. So the Knights will be back here at Knight Stadium Tuesday to face off against conference opponent Greensboro College. So come to Knight Stadium, tune in for that game as Brevard College Tornadoes will head back home to North Carolina to take on their fellow conference rival Fayette or Methodist College. So great game here today, and thank you for tuning in to this broadcast by Knights Broadcasting. I'm Tyler Wright, and have a great rest of your day. Go Knights!